also, you get in fights with people here that you don't expect. Like, it's not like fights where you just like, you know, I think I'm going to fight some guy my size. You get in fights with just random people of all, old ladies. You know, like, you fight with like a weird variety of people. And you, a lot of times about cabs. I get a lot of cab fights because there's just not enough cabs here. I don't know what's going on, but I cannot. Sometimes, there's no lie, using all of my whiteness, I cannot just stand at the corner. They just drive by me with like whiter people than me. I don't know what's happening. Gingers and albinos laughing at me, calling me mean words. I got a fight with this lady for a cab, and so I called her like, "Well, have you ever seen the movie Precious? Have you guys seen Precious? Black people, have you seen not Precious? Have you seen Precious? Okay, have you seen? But this is more important. This is a more important question. Have you seen the Human Centipede, which is like our Precious? That's like our very movie for white people to watch." It's like the same kind of thing, like, it's like people trapped in a bad situation, they don't know how to eat right. You know? They don't have a good diet, so it's like, it doesn't end up good for them. But here's my problem with Precious. That's not a true story. That's made up. Do you know that? That's not a real girl. They made her up. Why are you making up this girl and doing these things to her? What, like, who's getting helped by that from Precious? Because I'll tell you who's not getting helped. Girls that look like Precious, their lives are destroyed right now. Their lives are ruined by that movie. Because I got news for you. You piss me off and look like Precious, I'm gonna call you Precious. Like, you don't even have to look like it that much. So, I called this lady White Precious. And she looked very surprised. Like, she thought she couldn't get called Precious because she was white. Bam, White Precious! That's how clever I am. Quick on my feet. Because we were fighting over a cab, you know? And I was just running late. I was an hour late for something. I couldn't find any cabs. And I finally see one cab coming. And there's White Precious getting my cab. But I didn't call her White Precious for that. I went up to her. I go, "Excuse me, miss. Do you think we could share this cab? Like, I'm really desperate and I'm late. And I'll pay for your ride wherever you got to go. I just got to get to where I'm going." And then this is her exact reaction. "Oh my God, get the fuck away from me. Help. Help me. Help me. I'm doing exactly what she did. Like if you were being sexually assaulted in broad daylight, how you should yell, because I asked to share a cab. And I didn't call her White Precious for that, okay? The first thing I did was check to see if my dick was out, just to be extra, like before we start yelling White Precious at people, maybe your penis is on the outside of your pants. And that's why you can't, you know? So everybody's yelling and there's no cabs for you. Miss, please, I'm desperate. Can you? I'll pay any amount of money that you want if you would just let me cram in there." Yeah. So it was in my pants. I go, "Shut up, White Precious. Nobody's coming at you in a sexual way. What am I, your dad?" That is a direct, I'm telling you, a real quote from me. Yeah, I said that. And then and she goes, "If you don't stop harassing me, I'm gonna call the police." I go, "Call a cop right now. I wanna see a cop's face when you tell him that I attempted to scale and rape you. I want him to write that on a, I want him to take out a pad and have to write that with a straight face. That in broad daylight, I thought I'd throw it all away and tackle a dump truck and lift up his flannel shirt to find a fucking opening. Call a cop, I'll wait, call a cop. Yeah, I take it too far sometimes. Way overboard with that. And then she did call the cops. And it got kind of real because I don't know if you ever heard yourself getting described to the police by someone who's calling the police, but it's very upsetting. Like, you know how you stick out? Like, "He has very strange eyebrows and nostrils." I don't know, he's Turkish or something? I don't know, what the hell? And then she goes, "He has a blue gym bag." And when she said blue gym bag, I was like, oh shit, because I had just bought like all my weed for the month that like I had in this bag. That's why I was late, because I was buying a month's supply of weed. By the way, don't buy a month's supply of weed. I'm not gonna make it last a month, idiot. So, one second, I'm real cocky. I'm like, yeah, fatso, I'd like to see, oh God, weed. And I had to run, it. I ran into traffic and hid at CVS for 20 minutes while cops came. So, the moral of the story is, you don't have to be nice to people, but just don't carry illegal shit on you. That's all my time, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for coming on the show. I appreciate it.